If you thought peppers could only grow outdoors in soil, think again. We've grown spicy serranos, habaneros, and jalapenos, and even sweet peppers, all indoors using simple hydroponic setups. In today's video, we're sharing our 30-day growth updates and finally harvesting our habaneros. On June 12th, our freshly planted sweet pepper seedlings just began emerging from the medium. By June 16th, some sprouts had stretched higher while others were still taking their time. Of the three varieties, long blend showed the fastest growth, tangerine lagged behind, and banana peppers landed in between. Throughout this period, I occasionally added our fertilizer water mix to the tray to prevent drying out. It's the same mix used for our hydroponic habanero peppers. Today, I topped off the habanero system's water as it's been consuming water fast to support all the pepper growth. After refilling the habanero system, I checked on our jalapenos in the miniature DIY DWC setup. I'll link the build below. They look amazing. The leaf color is deep green, and thanks to hand pollinating with a Q-tip, we're already seeing little jalapeno fruits forming. It's nearly time to top off their reservoir. On June 19th, we spotted our first habanero ripening. By June 20th, it was fully ripe and ready to harvest. And not long after, we sliced into it. The heat was very intense, but the flavor and aroma were beautifully floral. In fact, some of our family said it was the best habanero that they had ever tried. June 22nd brought good news. The sweet peppers had grown enough to move into the system. But first, I wanted to train their roots downward. So I set up the white mesh tray from our deep sprouting tray kit, transfer the cubes into it, and fill the green tray with fertilizer water to the cube base. The plan was to let the roots grow down into the reservoir over a few days. Since the long blend peppers were ready, I built a DIY mini DWC system for them. I then adjusted the air pump, added an air stone and tubing, installed the neck cups, transferred the plants, and filled the reservoir until the solution just touched the bottom of the cups. Now we're finished. June 24th, we spotted a few more habaneros ready to harvest. After picking them, I mixed a batch of fresh fertilizer water to top off both the habanero and jalapeno systems. I added the water to the first system, then checked everything before topping off the jalapeno reservoir. I decided to set up a time-lapse focusing on our front cluster habaneros. But before that, I installed a one-way non-return check valve on each air pump. Over the next few days, I continued to watch their growth, harvesting habaneros and running the time lapse. We ended up with an epic 165-hour sequence. As of today, July 14th, we've harvested 106 habanero peppers, and around 14 more are still ripening across the 9 plants. A few days ago, I moved the habaneros into a much larger system to observe their response. Soon, we'll build more mini systems for the other sweet peppers, and I'm happy to report that the long peppers are loving their new setup. Happy growing, and thanks for joining us. And I'd love to hear, what are your favorite peppers to grow?